Are three of us here at the desk. You know what that means. It is time for Fugitive Friday.
Trish Rao with Crime Stoppers is here with us. Trish, who do we need to look out for?
Quite the roundup today. And we're starting off our list this week with a young man who brought a loaded handgun into a local high school. Devallon Harris spent nearly 10 months in lockup after bringing the weapon with 8 live rounds onto campus. Fortunately, another student saw the weapon and immediately reported it to administrators, who were able to remove Harris and the gun from school grounds. Despite the fact that he's only 19 years old, Harris has already established himself as a familiar face to law enforcement, with felony arrests dating back to age 13 when he was busted for burglary and grand theft. Since then, he's been in and out of the system for additional charges, including battery by strangulation. Harris just finished his last stint behind bars a few weeks ago, and already he's back in violation of his probation. Harris is 5'6", 130 pounds, with a history of violent tendencies. He was last known to be living in Lehigh, and upon his next arrest, he will be held without bond. Next up is a Fort Myers man who went on a multi-day crime spree, which ultimately landed him in prison. Earlier this week, Tadarian Jackson violated terms of his state probation on the heels of his latest arrest for robbery and armed carjacking. His antics started when Jackson stole a car in Lehigh Acres and later used it to follow a woman home from a local gas station. When she exited the car, Jackson carjacked her at gunpoint and fled the area. The following day, another victim caught him breaking into a car in Cape Coral, which ended up in a police chase and his eventual apprehension. He found himself behind bars locally for 11 months, followed by a little more than 6 years in prison. Jackson was just released in March, and already he's finding himself back in trouble with the law. This 27-year-old offender has a lengthy history of felony crimes to include burglary, grand theft, fraud, and resisting, among other charges. He's 5'7", 150 pounds, and has several tattoos, including a money bag on his chest, Boy Jackson inked on his hands, and Wacko written on his left arm. And upon his next arrest, Jackson will be held without bond. Also on the run this week is a repeat offender whose reckless actions left another man with critical and potentially permanent injuries. Melvin Santana is currently on the run after violating probation following an arrest for leaving a crash with serious injuries. Witnesses say Santana was showing off his car's engine at a gas station when he and another driver decided to take to the road for a race. They say Santana started speeding down the road, and when he came to a red light, he plowed through the intersection and struck an oncoming van. The other driver sustained injuries, and the passenger in his car was critically wounded. But instead of staying on scene, as the law mandates, Santana chose to run. Investigators eventually caught up with the 29-year-old and jailed him for 8 months for his irresponsible actions. He was later placed on probation, which he violated earlier this week. To date, this Fort Myers fugitive has 7 previous bookings for the sale and delivery of cocaine, battery, domestic violence, hit and run, and disorderly intoxication. He is 5'8", 200 pounds, and is known to use the alias of Chico. Santana has several tattoos, including the phrase, "There is beauty in danger and danger in beauty," inked on his right arm. And last on this week's list is a woman who has repeatedly made the dangerous decision to get behind the wheel after imbibing in far too many adult beverages. J.K. Thomas is currently wanted on charges relating to her latest DUI that happened last April. Deputies say they initially spotted the 62-year-old driving 25 in a 50-mile-an-hour zone. She then sped up to 55 while crossing the center line several times, which prompted a traffic stop. Officers noted that Thomas was visibly out of sorts and reeked of urine and booze. After turning her license and registration over, Thomas decided to leave the scene and drive to her house, despite officers' orders to stay put. After she missed her driveway and exited the car, she tried to avoid this deputy that was standing right in front of her. However, she quickly found herself in handcuffs and in the back of a patrol car. She later told officers that she'd had 16 shots of straight Jägermeister, but thought that she was still okay to drive. It should be noted that this was her second DUI in just a short amount of time. She was released from jail under certain conditions, which she failed to comply with 2 weeks ago. Thomas is 5'2", 90 pounds, and was last known to be living in St. James City. And as always, if you recognize any of the fugitives we've featured here today, you're asked to call the Crime Stoppers hotline. That number is 1-800-780-TIPS. All callers will remain anonymous and will be eligible for a cash reward of up to $3,000. Need these four behind bars and definitely off the roadways to keep us all safe.
16 shots?
And thought she was okay.
On that note, Memorial Day weekend, you know, obviously it's a somber holiday. We're remembering folks that deserve it. But, you know, so many people do use it as a weekend of drinking and partying and stuff. Call an Uber. Yeah. Make sure you have a sober driver, all that stuff, because you guys are not messing around this weekend.
Yeah, we'll have extra patrols out on the roadways this weekend looking for impaired drivers. So just make a plan, have a designated driver, ride share, whatever it takes, but
so
get home safe.
Nowadays.
Absolutely. No excuses.
Yeah. Thank you, Trish.
Thanks,
we appreciate you. All right, team.